Good morning, students. Today we let us discuss about the first chapter, reproduction in organisms. As we have different systems like digestive system, circulatory system, respiratory system, excretory system, nervous system, we have a reproductive system. In reproduction, two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Reproduction is a biological process in which organism can produce their young ones. Reproduction is an important characteristic feature of living organisms. It is an essential life of process. By that, the organism can produce its young ones. Is reproduction is essential to the organisms? Yes. If organism not reproduced, what happens? If organism not reproduced, that species become extinct. Because every organism has a limited lifespan. After that, that will die. So, every organism has to reproduce before the death. What is a lifespan? The period from birth, till natural death is called a lifespan. The time period from birth till natural death is called a lifespan. The lifespan is vary from an organism to another organism. That may range from 1 day to 4,000 years. The lifespan has four stages: juvenile phase, maturity phase, aging or senescence, and a death. The stage when organism develops the capacity to reproduce. The stage when organism develops the capacity to reproduce, that time, is called juvenility. For example, in a human, from the time of birth till attain puberty, that time period is called a juvenility. Only growth and developmental process takes place in that time. Next, maturity. When once organism reaches puberty, that start reproduce for certain time. This stage of reproduction is called the maturity. This stage of reproduction is called a maturity. After few years or few months or few days of time, after some time, that organism gradually loses the capacity of reproduction and that start become aging, becoming old. This progressive aging in the body of an organism is called aging, and it is known as senescence. Senescence become aging, or becoming old. Finally, that organism will die. There is permanent cessation What is death? The permanent cessation of all vital activities is called death. So these are the four stages takes place in everyone's lifetime. First, juvenility. Next, maturity. And aging or a senescence. And last one is a death. Now, let us discuss about the reproduction. What is a reproduction? The creation by a life from a similar life form is called reproduction. Or reproduction is a biological process in which an organism gives rise to their young ones. All organisms reproduce in a same method? No. The organisms reproduce in a different ways. They are all broadly classified into two types. Asexual reproduction and a sexual reproduction. So, reproduction are of two types. Asexual reproduction and a sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is the formation of new individuals. Asexual reproduction is a formation of new individuals without inviting the formation and fusion of gametes. It is also called uniparental reproduction. Asexual reproduction is also called uniparental reproduction. What about sexual reproduction? Sexual reproduction is a biparental reproduction because it involves formation and fusion of the gametes. Here, the gametes will be produced from the opposite sexes and they will be fused. So, this is called sexual reproduction. Here, that sharing of genetic material takes place from male partner and a female partner. Here, the offspring produced by sexual reproduction have two parents. One is a male parent, another one is a female parent. But in asexual reproduction, that offspring have only one parent. That's why that is a uniparental reproduction, whereas sexual reproduction is a biparental reproduction. See, asexual reproduction. Here, offsprings produced are identical, both morphologically as well as genetically, they will be identical. And if the all offsprings are identical, both by morphologically and genetically, are called clones. They are called clones. You know about parthenogenesis that you studied in a first year. What is parthenogenesis? Parthenogenesis is a process of development of egg without fertilization. Similarly, here there is a apomixis. Apomixis is the formation of new individuals through asexual reproduction of without involving the formation and fusion of the gametes. That we call the apomixis. Usually that related to plants. Even plants will produce us seeds without fusion of the gametes, that we call the apomixis. It involves only mitotic cell divisions and is also termed somatogenic reproduction. The type of reproduction is called the somatogenic reproduction. Here, today we discuss only about the asexual reproduction. Means I already told that asexual reproduction is a uniparental reproduction, and that offsprings will be morphologically and genetically same are called clones. Here, first we learn about the reproduction in a lower organisms like that is protozoans and fungus, and in bacteria, how that organisms can reproduce. Asexual reproduction in a lower organisms. To take an that organism, amoeba. Amoeba is a single-celled eukaryotic organism. How it can reproduce? Amoeba will reproduce by binary fission. It is a division of the adult parent body or a parent cell into nearly equal daughter cells during a favorable climatic conditions. When climatic conditions are favorable, divides and produces two equal sized daughter cells. In binary fission, the first nucleus will divide. In every time that during a cell division, the nucleus will first divide. That process of division of nucleus is called karyokinesis. Karyokinesis is followed by, means after completion of the karyokinesis, the cytoplasm of the cell start to divide. This process is called cytokinesis. That is called cytokinesis. After completion of the cytokinesis, nearly equal sized two daughter cells will be formed. So just it is a type of mitosis. Type of a mitosis, one kind of cell division. But in amoeba, mitosis is a one kind of reproduction. The organisms undergoing binary fission are called immortal. Most of these unicellular organisms are called immortal because there is no natural death for these organisms. When that adult cell divides, again it produces a young daughter cells. They will grow and develop, attain a maturity. After maturity, no death. Again it divides and it survive as young ones. So that's why most of the microorganisms are considered as a immortal. Okay, this is one type of asexual reproduction noticed in a lower organisms. Next, zoospores. Some algae like Chlamydomonas, some algae reproduces by producing a spores. You may see that these are the spores. These are spores and these are a flagella, nucleus and a cytoplasm. Some algae produces a microscopic spores. These spores are very active. Motile means move from place to place. And flagellated, they have a locomotory structure, flagella. See, flagella, these are locomotory structure. So flagellated, which undergoes cell division in a favorable condition. So these are the spores produced from some algae, microscopic, very active, motile, and a flagellated. They will divide, undergo cell division during a favorable condition and develops a new algal filament. So these spores are called zoospores, it is another type of asexual reproduction noticed in lower organisms. Next, some organisms like Hydra or yeast reproduces by budding, by formation of the external bud. It is actually an unequal sized cell division. Budding is a type of asexual reproduction in which one or more unicellular or multicellular outgrowths, because here that bud produced is external, outgrowths called buds develop, then it detached or separate from a parent and lead it to an independent life. So this type of reproduction is called budding. It is commonly noticed in yeast and also in Hydra. That is, Hydra also reproduces by budding method. How many types we learned? Now three types. One, binary fission, amoeba. Second, zoospores, that is algae, and budding by yeast. Next, gemmules. Next is a gemmules. Gemmules are internal buds. Yeast reproduces by external buds. Gemmules are the internal buds. Internal buds formed in unfavorable conditions. These produced in unfavorable conditions and developed into new individual. Developed into new individual during favorable conditions. Example, sponges. Example, sponges. The water sponges, do you know? In a first year, you learned that the organisms placed in a first phylum, Porifera. Porifera, the organisms belongs in phylum Porifera, are generally called sponges. Sponges. So these sponges, during unfavorable conditions, produces buds in its cavity called spongocoel. Spongocoel. Sponges have a cavity inside. So that cavity, this cavity is called a spongocoel. See how many birds, internal birds are called gemmules are produced here. And when favorable conditions return, each gemmule is developed into a new sponges. It is another kind of reproduction. Next type is conidia. This type of asexual reproduction is noticed in fungus Penicillium notatum. Fungus like Penicillium notatum, the world famous penicillin antibiotic is produced from this fungus, that is Penicillium notatum. See, at the tip of the each hyphae, the filament of the fungus are called hyphae. At the tip of each hyphae, there are a group of cells. That cluster is called conidia. So these conidia are released into air. In a wet place, it start germinate and produces a new body. So this is another type of reproduction noticed in a fungus. Few species of a fungus like Penicillium notatum. How many types of asexual reproduction we learned? First, I explained about a binary fission noticed in amoeba. Then zoospores noticed in some varieties of algae. Next, I explained about the external buds noticed in yeast. Then gemmules produced in sponges. Conidia noticed in a fungus like Penicillium notatum. Apart from these types, One more that is a reproductive method is fragmentation. So it takes place in some varieties of the algae, aquatic plants, aquatic organisms. It is a type of asexual reproduction in which the parental body breaks into two or more fragments. The algae filaments is breaks into two or more filaments by water currents or mechanical injury, and each body fragment developed into an organism. It is found in some flatworms. Flatworms. Do you know in which under which phylum that flatworms are placed? Phylum Platyhelminthes. Example Planaria, liver fluke. See that tapeworm. Tapeworm, Planaria, liver fluke, all are placed in the phylum Platyhelminthes. These flatworms reproduces by fragmentation. If one animal body cut into two parts, each part is developed into a complete new organism. And sea anemones and echinoderms, echinoderms, they also shows this kind of reproduction. These are all the types of asexual reproductions noticed in lower organisms. Now let us discuss about the asexual reproduction in a higher plants. Asexual reproduction in a higher plants. Higher plants, we all know that plant has parts like root, stem, leaves, flower, fruit and a seed. Of these six parts, first three, root, stem, leaves are called vegetative part. Vegetative part, and flower, fruit and seeds are called the reproductive part, means sexual reproductive part. Root is a vegetative part. Stem and leaves are also vegetative part. Some higher plants reproduces from these parts. Which part? From the root or from stem or from leaf. Together called vegetative parts. Plant reproduces from these parts is called vegetative propagation. That is also called vegetative propagation. For the purpose of vegetative propagation, plants develop certain organ, special organ that only meant for vegetative reproduction, vegetative propagation. That special part is developed in that plant is called vegetative propagal. That is called the vegetative propagal. One vegetative propagule is the rhizome. Rhizome. Rhizome is a vegetative propagule. It is a vegetative propagule noticed in plants like that is ginger. The plant ginger develops it horizontal underground part, special part for a reproduction is called a rhizome. See, rhizomes are underground modified stem growing horizontally meant for asexual reproduction, and also that perform one more function, that is storage of a food. The food is also stored in that part, and in which the decay of older parts isolates from the parent the newly formed branches that lead to independent life. So this type of asexual reproduction we find in plants like ginger. So ginger is a modified underground stem. Next, tuber. Eyes of the tuber. This observed in a plant like a potato. Potato we using as a vegetable. So the tuber of a potato or eyes of the tuber is a swollen apical part of an underground stem. Potato is also underground stem. Ginger is also underground stem. These are not a roots, modified underground stem. Part of an underground stem, branch and base number of nodes and eyes. Nodes, see that even ginger also has nodes and internodes, scaly leaves and adventitious roots. Potato tuber also has nodes, internodes and eyes. These all eyes are the axillary buds. New plants are produced from the buds of these eyes. So example, potato. Here we learned, in this slide we learned two types, that is rhizome and eyes of the tuber. Rhizome in a ginger, eyes of tuber in a potato plant. Next, suckers. Suckers, this is a basal shoot. The shoot part found towards the basal region, which develops into a new plant. Example, chrysanthemum. It is an ornamental plant. The flowers are used to make a garland. Chrysanthemum. It is a flowering plants. Here the lower or basal shoots are used for the vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction or asexual reproduction. Next, runner. Runners are the vegetative propagals noticed in plant like oxalis. Runners, these are aerial weak stem. What about rhizome? In rhizome in potato we find underground parts, but this is a aerial weak stem. When touches the ground gives off adventitious roots at nodes. So it will grow when it touches the soil from the node part. So many roots developed are called adventitious roots. Do you know which roots are called adventitious roots? The roots developed from other than radical are commonly called adventitious roots. When older parts of the plant die, the branches separate from the parental plant and forms independent life. Example, oxalis. Okay. One more type of asexual reproduction or a vegetative propagal is a offset. What is offset? It is a short, horizontal branch producing a cluster of leaves above surface of water, noticed in a hydrophytes or a aquatic plant, and the cluster of roots below water is called a upset. Upset, it occurs in some aquatic plants. Breaking of upset helps in progression or development into a new plant. This type of vegetative propagal upset we can see in the plant Acornia or water hyacinth. Next vegetative propagal is a bulbil. Bulbil is a vegetative propagal. It is a vegetative propagal noticed in plant like agave. The bulbil is a large sized, fleshy, because thick and wet, fleshy vegetative propagal which bears number of buds with variable position on a plant. In agave, the plant like agave, bulbils are actually modified floral buds. Bulbils are the modified floral buds noticed in a plant like again. Last one, even some plants like bryophyllum reproduces by its leaf buds. By its leaf buds, like some plants produces adventitious buds on their leaf margin. They usually remain dormant when leaf attached with plant. The leaves, when in contact with moist soil, develop new plants along with margins. So this type of reproduction we can see in the plants like bryophyllum. Bryophyllum is a xerophytic plant and it's also a ornamental plant. To this point, I'll stop now. I'll